And you've talked about the importance of CLIO in the development of modern education. Would you please tell us why it is so popular nowadays and what are the prospects of it, its development in our country?
Certainly. Well, CLIO has been popular because really it builds on a lot of work that has happened in the past. Student-centered learning, participatory learning, simply getting students involved and speaking more in the class, that alone will make better language learning in the country. If you blend with that, as in CLIL, such concepts as teaching the content at the same time as the language, for example, teaching engineering and Russian at the same time, that's what separates CLIL from some of the other methodologies where you may be learning English for engineering and then learning engineering.
And how long is the usual period over introducing the CLIO techniques into the process of education? On the example of some European countries, the US?
Sure. Typically, it's best to do some sort of analysis before there's any major change to an educational system. Luxembourg, as I think I've mentioned before, they did some significant study first, saw how the languages are actually used in the society, and then designed the educational system around that. In other ones, such as in India, they tried pushing CLIL immediately, and the students found the level of content was too much, so they backed off. They're still using CLIL, but they've adjusted it for their society and are slowly integrating the content over some few years.
Could you please provide any kind of forecast of CLIL development in our place?
I'm not sure I understand the question, I'm sorry.
What about our country and the development of CLIO here?
Well, it has promise. As with anything, it always depends on if it has support at all levels. Any methodology will only work if it has the knowledge and support of the teachers, but also the knowledge and support of those who support the teachers. It has promise because with CLIL you can do several things at once, so it saves some time. It has promise because if applied correctly, not trying to do three languages in the same class, but one class in, say, Russian, and a different class then will be in Kazakh, a different class in English, applied correctly, it holds quite a bit of promise, but it needs support at all levels to be able to support the teachers and provide the students with what they need.
Mm-hmm. And maybe one more question about teacher. Mm-hmm. What means to be a teacher for you?
Well, I like how you said that for you, because that can be different for different people. In my opinion, being a good teacher, it means caring enough about the future of your students to help them right now. And I think it can be a common trap for teachers to think only about right now and not realize that they're having an effect on the students throughout their lives. Beyond that, you can learn techniques, you can learn methods, but if you can keep your eye on the fact that you are helping to form a person, it makes a big difference in your teaching.
And what about presenting? As an experienced presenter, will you recommend to the young teachers who would like to provide a workshop or just a plenary speech like you did, maybe some?
The number one thing, I would say from what I've seen in Kazakhstan is people need to have the students participating more. There is still a tendency to stand in front of the board and give lots of words and speak a lot, and students need to engage in their learning. And if you notice, it's difficult in a plenary speech, but even in the plenary speech, I had people raise their hands, I had people talk with the spoon. And the more you can get the students involved, the more they will learn.
Well, thank you so much for the piece of advice you've given to all of us, and for your plenary speech as well as your workshops. They were very important for the future development of our self or just improvement, as well as interesting and informative.
Well, and I would like to thank KazTEA and everyone involved. Everyone has been very welcoming and kind here. And the teachers show a lot of promise as long as they keep working toward that student-centered learning.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm.
Well, good afternoon, Mr. Mitchell. We know that you are the English language fellow for Polish. Mm-hmm. Could you please tell a little bit about your experience about working in this position?
Sure. As the fellow for the south of Kyrgyzstan, we primarily face lots of challenges, limited resources, changing curriculum, and just students and teachers who really want to learn but don't have the resources and sometimes the training to do so. So my primary responsibility as the fellow for this U.S. Department of State program has been professional development more than anything. So I work very closely with faculty and teachers to improve the quality of their teaching and in terms of overall academic quality.
And what is more challenging for you, to train the teachers, to prepare them to make ready students for their future profession, or to develop some standards of education?
So developing standards is always a mutual process. We have to have input from multiple parties, including ministries of education, government oversight, all of those areas. It's a fun process, but it takes a long time. And I find that no matter whether we're trying to improve instruction among teachers or we're trying to develop new standards.
And what professional qualities do you especially appreciate in other teachers of the same field?
For sure. I think two of the most important qualities are consistency and dedication. You have to provide consistent instructional services of a high quality, otherwise your efforts can often be thwarted. In terms of dedication, this is sometimes not the most rewarding job. You have long hours with little compensation and sometimes a lot of demands on you. So remaining dedicated to the profession in spite of the circumstances and really committed to improving the quality of education in your country is of the utmost importance.
Thank you so much. And the last question, please. Maybe not the question, but a kind of suggestion.
Sure.
Could you please give a piece of advice to our teachers? How to become the good ones? How to just cope with some difficulties in presenting the new material, or just overcoming the barriers in educating the students?
For sure. I think one of the biggest challenges throughout Kyrgyzstan and perhaps Kazakhstan as well is a lack of communicative competence. Mm-hmm. I would encourage teachers to really focus on communicative language teaching, where students develop the skills to be able to interact and to really communicate using the target language. The single easiest way to do this, to develop those skills among teachers, is to interact with native speakers as much as possible. So that would be my one bit of advice to everyone.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
It was very nice to communicate with you, and of course we hope that the teachers who are going to watch our interview also will use the kind of advice you gave us.
Thank you for inviting us to Kazakhstan and you to your wonderful conference. We really appreciate it. Thank you.
It's Ador, and I'm from Shymkent. Now we've been like organizing the KazTEA for 2 days, and it was so interesting. Many teachers from different parts of Kazakhstan came and gathered in Shymkent, and it was so fruitful, and a lot of the ideas came up, and we're so happy to have all of you in Shymkent, and we hope that in the future the next KazTEA is going to be in Aktobe, and we hope that it will be also interesting and fun, and a lot of information they will get. So now we'll hand our post or to Aktobe. Thank you for all.
All right, I'm obviously representing representing my city, actually. My name is Bekhtazar. I'm actually quite new for this organization. It's just my first maybe conference. I'm just getting going with all the stuff, and I pretty much love it. I got tons and tons of things here, not just from the foreign comers like EL specialists like Magdo, Nathan Carr, there were Martin Curtis as well from Oxford University Press, and many people, but also the local teachers from Kazakhstan. They're doing a very great job as well. I really loved it. And I hope you know, when we have the same in October, we'll try to make a little bit better. Yeah, it was great, but we'll try to jump even higher. Yeah, that's very loud words, and I hope we can do it.
So
you're welcome.
So see you in October, yes?
Yeah.
Okay.